हेलो स्टूडेंट, सो आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ द मेन डाइजेस्टिव ऑर्गन, लेट सी द एक्सेसिव डाइजेस्टिव ऑर्गन्स। सो एक्सेसिव डाइजेस्टिव ऑर्गन दैट इंक्लूड्स द लिवर, पैनक्रियाज, गॉल ब्लैडर एंड द सलाइवरी ग्लैंड्स। सो नाउ लेट स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम द लिवर। सो लिवर, इट इज अ लार्ज सॉलिड ग्लैंड सिचुएटेड इन द राइट अपर क्वाड्रेंट ऑफ द एब्डोमेन। ठीक है, देन इन द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म और द इन द लिविंग सब्जेक्ट्स दैट लिवर, इट इज़ द रेडिश ब्राउन इन कलर एंड सॉफ्ट इन कंसिस्टेंसी एंड इट इज़ वेरी मच फ्रेबाइल इन नेचर। द वेट ऑफ दैट द लिवर इन द ह्यूमन बींग दैट इज़ नियर अबाउट द 1600 ग्राम्स इन द मेल्स एंड नियर अबाउट द 1300 ग्राम्स इन द फीमेल। सो लेट सी द डिटेल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द लिवर। सो हेयर दैट इज़ द लिवर, that is also called the heper and in Ayurveda it is called the yakrut. Okay, so it is the largest gland which is present or occupies in the right upper part of the abdominal cavity and it consists of both exocrine and endocrine part, means that is the mixed type of the largest gland. ठीक है, देन इट शुड बी परफॉर्म अ वाइड रेंज ऑफ मेटाबॉलिक एक्टिविटीज विच इज़ नेसेसरी फॉर द होम्योस्टेसिस, दैट इज द न्यूट्रिशन एंड द इम्यून रिस्पॉन्स आल्सो। द फंक्शंस विच इज डन बाय द लिवर, दैट इज फर्स्ट इट सिक्रेट द बाइल एंड स्टोर द ग्लाइकोजन, सेकंड वन इट सिंथेसाइज द सीरम प्रोटीन एंड द लिपिड, थर्ड वन इट डिटॉक्सिफाइज द ब्लड फ्रॉम द एंडोजिनस एंड एक्जोजिनस सब्सटेंसेस दैट एंटर इनटू दैट द सर्कुलेशन, एंड द फोर्थ एंड लास्ट वन इट प्रोड्यूसेस द हीमोपोएटिक सेल्स ऑफ ऑल टाइप्स ड्यूरिंग द फिटल लाइफ। सो दैट इज द मेन इंपॉर्टेंट फंक्शन विच इज डन बाय द लिवर। आफ्टर देन वी शुड हैव टू सी द एग्जैक्ट लोकेशन ऑफ द लिवर। सो फॉर दिस we should have to see that is the ninth region of the abdomen and we should have to see that is the exact location of the liver. So it should be have the wedge shape, here you can see, and the weight of the gland, it is near about the 500 gram. Then it receives the blood 1500 ml per minute. Then location, so it should be located, most of the part that should be located into the right hypochondric region, then the epigastric region and the left hypochondric region. So here you can see that is the exact location of the liver, that is the right hypochondrium, epigastric and the left lobe, that should be into the left hypochondric region. Then we should have to see that is the external features of the liver. So the external features, so color of the liver, that is the red brown in color, and in the external features it is wedge shaped liver present two well defined surfaces, that is the two surfaces are present, the diaphragmatic surface and the visceral surface. So here you can see this is the visceral surface and here that is the diaphragmatic surface. Then the diaphragmatic surface, it is again divided into the five surface, that is this is the anterior surface, then exact posterior surface, then the superior surface, this one, then the inferior surface and the right surface. So these are five surfaces which is done by the diaphragmatic surface. After then the visceral surface, or that is called the inferior surface. So visceral surface, it is relatively flat or concave and directed downwards, backwards and to the left. So here you can see this is it separate in front from the diaphragmatic surface by a sharp border, this one, so it is called the inferior border, and behind from diaphragm by the posterior layer of the coronary ligament. So here you can see this is the coronary ligament, both side, this is the superior coronary ligament and this is the inferior coronary ligament. So here you can see, okay, then it shows that is some features, that is fossa for gallbladder, here you can see fissure for ligamentum teres, that this one, and porta hepatis, this one. After then the inferior border, this one. So it separates the diaphragmatic surface from the visceral surface. So this one, that is the diaphragmatic surface, and that should be divide this border by the visceral surface. Then it is rounded laterally. So here you can see it is rounded laterally, where it separates the right lateral surface from the inferior surface. So this one and this one. It presents two notches, that is first it is for notch for the ligamentum teres, so here, and it is located just right of the median plane. Then second one, that is the cystic notch, so here it is located 5 cm to the right of the median plane and often correspond to the fundus of the gall bladder. So here you can see, or posteriorly you can see this one, that is the inferior border, and here that is the fundus for the gall bladder. In the epigastrium, it extends from right 9th costal cartilage to the 8th left costal cartilage, and in the median plane, this one, it lies in the transpyloric plane. Okay, then the lobes of the liver. So there are two types of lobes are present, or it should be classified into the two types. First, that is the anatomical lobe, and second one, that is the physiological lobe or functional lobe. So let's see the anatomical lobe. The lobes of the liver, anatomical lobe. So on the diaphragmatic surface, the liver should be divided into the two lobes. That is here large, that is the right lobe, and this is the small, that is the left lobe, by the attachment of the falciform ligament. So here you can see, this is the falciform ligament. So because of the presence of the falciform ligament, the liver that should be divided into the right and the left lobe. Okay? Then on visceral surface, the liver should be divided. So this is the visceral surface, and here the liver should be divided into that, this is the large right lobe, this is the small left lobe, and this is the caudate lobe, and this one, that is the quadrate lobe. So here you can see, this is the quadrate lobe, this one small. So let's see, that is the lobes in detail. The right lobe, it is larger than the left lobe, and it forming near about 5/6 part of the lobe, and it consists of all 5 surfaces of the liver, and on posterior side it gives the caudate and the quadrate lobe. So here you can see, this is the caudate lobe and this is the quadrate lobe. So let's see, that is the caudate lobe, this one. So caudate lobe, it is situated by right by a groove for inferior vena cava. So here you can see, that is the groove for inferior vena cava, and left by the fissure for ligamentum venosum. So this one, this is for the ligamentum venosum, and inferiorly by the porta hepatis. So this one, this is the porta hepatis, and above continuous with the superior surface. So that is the superior surface. So this quadrangular area, it is called the caudate lobe. Okay? Then below to, just below to this porta hepatis, it is connected to the right lobe by the caudate process. Okay? Then quadrate lobe, this one. So quadrate lobe, it is situated in the inferior surface, and it is rectangular in shape. So here you can see, it is shape of this. It is bounded anteriorly by the inferior border. So here you can see, that is the inferior border. Posteriorly by the porta hepatis. So this one, this is the porta hepatis. And on right by the fossa for gallbladder. So here. And on the left for the fissure of ligamentum teres. So this one. Okay. So this is the
quadrate lobe, that is the rectangular in shape. After then we should have to see, that is the porta hepatis. So this one, so porta hepatis, it is the deep transverse fissure about 5 cm long, situated on inferior surface of the right lobe of the liver. So here you can see this one. It lies between the caudate lobe and the quadrate lobe. So this one, that is the caudate lobe, and this is the quadrate lobe. The portal vein, hepatic artery, and the hepatic plexus of nerve that should be entered throughout the porta hepatis. While right and left hepatic duct and few lymphatics, they are leave from that the porta hepatis. Then the tip of the porta hepatis provide the attachment to lesser omentum. So here you can see that should be attached the lesser omentum, which is at other part, it is attached to the lesser curvature of the stomach. Relation with the porta hepatis from behind to forward, the portal vein, the hepatic artery, and the hepatic duct. So these are the relations of the porta hepatis. After then we should have to see, that is the functional lobes of the liver. This is the physiological or the functional lobes. So on the basis of the intrahepatic distribution of the hepatic artery, the portal vein, and the biliary duct, the liver can be divided into right and left functional lobes, and that is not corresponding to that the anatomical lobe. So here you can see, that is the right hepatic vein, that is the left hepatic vein, and that is the middle hepatic vein. So according to it, it should be divided, that is the right lobe into that the four functional lobe, and the left lobe into the four functional lobe. So the right lobe, that should be divided into that the anterior superior lobe and the anterior inferior lobe. Here you can see, that is the 8 and 5. So that is anterior superior lobe and the anterior inferior lobe. And then the posterior part or the posterior lobe, it should be again divided into the posterior superior lobe and posterior inferior lobe. So in this way, that is the four lobes that should be present on the right side. Then on the left side, it should be forming, that is first, that is the medial superior and medial inferior, that is the first and the fourth. So here you can see medial superior and medial inferior. And lateral most side, it should be forming the lateral superior and lateral inferior, that have the second and the third number. So in this way, that is the functional development or the functional lobes that should be forming into that the liver. And clinically, this functional or the segments, that is also called the segments of the liver. So that is very much important during that the liver surgery. So this is important because in the hepatic segments are not well defined as the bronchopulmonary segments. The anatomy of the hepatic segments is still controversial. Therefore, the true lobes rather than a segment should be resected in most of the instances of the partial hepatectomy. And this is important because a large volume of the liver, near about 80%, can be removed safely because the healthy hepatocytes have great capacity, have the regeneration, and the liver can be regrowth to its original size within 6 to 12 months. So that is the important clinical points related with the surgery related with the liver. Okay, so that is the importance of the functional lobes of the liver. Let's see, that is the relations of the liver. So firstly, we should have to see, that is the peritoneal relations, and then the visceral relations. So most of the peritoneal relations, so most of the part of the liver that should be covered by the peritoneum, and the area which is not covered by the peritoneum, these are. So first area, that is the bare area. So here you can see this area. This is the bare area, this one, that little quadrangular area. It is a triangular area on the posterior aspect of the right lobe. So here you can see, that is the posterior aspect of the liver. Then second one, that is the fossa for the gallbladder. It is present on the inferior surface of the liver.
Then third, the groove for the IVC. So here you can see this one. It is present on the posterior surface of the right lobe. Then the groove for the ligamentum venosum. So here this is the ligamentum venosum. And the porta hepatis. So this one. So this part that is not covered by the peritoneal membrane. Rather than the most of the part of the liver that should be covered by the peritoneal membrane. And it forms the ligaments related to that the liver. So there are two types of ligament forms by the peritoneal folds. So firstly, we should have to see that is the false ligament and the true ligament. So the false ligament that consists of the peritoneal fold, which includes the falciform ligament, coronary ligament, right triangular ligament, left triangular ligament, and the lesser omentum. So let's see that is the falciform ligament. So the falciform ligament, here in this diagram you can see that is the falciform ligament. So it is the sickle shaped fold of the peritoneum connected the liver to the under surface of the diaphragm and the anterior abdominal wall up to the umbilicus. So here you can see that is the falciform ligament. Okay, then second, it is the coronary ligament. So coronary ligament, here you can see this is the superior layer of coronary ligament and this one, second one, that is the inferior layer of the coronary ligament. Okay, so it is the triangular ligament or the triangular fold of the peritoneum connected to the bare area of the liver to the diaphragm, and it consists of two layer, that is the upper layer and the lower layer, this one. So upper layer that is reflected from the diaphragm to the liver, whereas the lower layer is reflected from the liver to the upper end of the kidney. So this one and this one. Okay? Then right triangular ligament. So it is small triangular fold of the peritoneum which connects the right lateral surface of the liver to the diaphragm. So here in this region. Right triangular ligament. So this one. Then the left triangular ligament. So here you can see the left triangular ligament. So it is very very small triangular fold of the peritoneum which connects the upper surface of the left lobe. So here. Then the lesser omentum. So lesser omentum, it is a fold of the peritoneum connected to the lesser curvature of the stomach and proximal 1 inch of duodenum to the visceral surface of the liver. So here, the hepatic attachment is a J shape, which is the vertical limb of the attachment. So here you can see J shape. And it is attached to the margin of fissure fold, the ligamentum venosum, and horizontal limb being attached to the margin slip of the porta hepatis. So here you can see that is attached to that the margin of the porta hepatis. Then the true ligament. So true ligament that include the ligamentum venosum and ligamentum teres. So here, firstly, we should have to see that is the ligamentum teres. So it is a remnant of the obliterated left umbilical vein and extends from the umbilicus to the left branch of the portal vein. So here, then the ligamentum venosum. So it is the remnant of obliterated ductus venosus. So here that should be present, which is in the fetal life. Connects the left branch of the portal vein with the IVC. So inferior vena cava. So that is the ligamentum venosum. So these are the peritoneal relations related with the liver.